Katie, you live in Italy where wearing a mask was required for months. How important is it?
And it still is, Carrie. We don't go into a shop or a restaurant without a mask on. They've just stopped shy of making us try to eat with our masks on. It seems to be what and the hard lockdown seem to be what contained the virus in Italy. So I don't understand why you argue with wearing a mask, because if you think it's an incursion into your freedoms, wait till you're in hard lockdown and you can't go outside to walk your dog for 4 months and then see if wearing a mask is such a big deal. For me, I don't think it is, because I've lived the former.
Katie, have you been following Victorians who are refusing to wear the mask, whether it be at Bunnings or you know, around jogging tracks or whatever? What would you say to them?
I just find it, I find the thinking behind it strange, Pete. I mean, on the one hand, I understand the thinking that people are like, this is all strange. Is this real? Is this happening? Is it a government conspiracy? Of course, people ask themselves questions like that when things are strange and could be a government conspiracy. However, I think that if you've had your freedoms denied you, the hill that you're choosing to die on is refusing to wear a mask is an odd hill, because there are so many other freedoms that we have learnt the hard way in Italy we can be denied. So wearing a mask, aside from anything else, it seems like a courtesy for people who work in shops all the time, who have to deal with strangers. They don't know what precautions we've taken. They don't know how healthy we are or where we've been. It just seems like politeness, courtesy and practicality to me.
Kate, give us a sense of what it's like in Italy now. We saw you go through hard lockdown up in Bologna. You're now down in the south in Puglia. Is it much more relaxed there?
Steve, it is so much more relaxed. It's as though COVID never happened. And I think that's a sense with the summer down here, and the south was much less affected than the north where we normally live. But people are splashing, jumping on the beach, brushing past each other in gelaterias. Still you see mainly older people with masks on, even when they're walking, but most people have just abandoned themselves unto the summer, I think in anticipation of maybe an autumn lockdown coming and making the most of it while they can.
A lot of Australians, I think, are just thinking, when am I going to be able to have a holiday again? I know a lot of Victorians are thinking, when are they going to be able to leave the state again? How good is that feeling when you finally get to have a bit of a holiday, Kate?
Oh, Carrie, it's like, you know what it's like? It's like the first time your baby sleeps through the night and you have that first moment where you wake up and go, have they died? Oh, well, hang on, I'll just have another 20 minutes sleep before I check. It's just a heavenly feeling, and it's a reminder of just what our lives were and what I firmly believe our lives will be again. We all have to believe that.
Hey, also, you were back in Australia recently to see your dad, who wasn't doing so well. How's he going now?
Oh, he's so good. He got out of hospital the day that we got a flight back out of Australia, me and my eldest son, and it was a testament to the power of love how he recovered when he saw us. It was amazing. He'd been in hospital for 6 weeks and it looked really bad. And we're so grateful. We're just so happy. Or happy we could leave him again.
Seeing your son with his hand on his back as well, you raised him right, Kate. Good on you. We love you lots and glad that you're finally getting some freedom and enjoying it. Speak to you soon.
You guys, the faith.